I'm going to describe how to use an interactive simulation that models a reversible reaction in a membrane reactor. This is an equilibrium limited reaction, and the idea is that we have a reaction of A plus B going to C plus D, and we get limited by equilibrium. If we can preferentially remove D through a membrane into an annular region, then we're going to push the equilibrium to the right and get a higher conversion of A and B, and therefore a higher flow rate of C leaving the reactor. So what I'm plotting here is the molar flow rate divided by the cross-sectional area. And I'm doing that because in the simulation, we can vary the diameter. So in order to make a relative comparison, we're looking at the flow rate per area. And then we're plotting this versus distance down the reactor. So the reactants A and B are fed in different concentrations. Now you can see in the case where we have significant permeates through the membrane, the flow rate of D is much lower than the flow rate of C, even though the stoichiometry is 1-to-1, because we're removing D through the membrane. As a result, we're getting a higher conversion of C. The simulation is located on the Wolfram site on the location indicated in blue here. Now we'll go and look at the simulation and look at how changing the rate constant or the equilibrium constant or the permeance, the flux divided by the driving force basically through the membrane, or the reactor diameter will change the flow rate of C. We're trying to increase or maximize the flow rate of C. So here's the interactive simulation. We're plotting, remember, molar flow rate divided by the cross-sectional area, because we're going to be able to change the reactor diameter, versus distance down the reactor. The product C is what we're desired to make, and we're moving D through the membrane. So you can see when the permeate is significant, the flow rate of D significantly lower than the flow rate of C. If I make it where there's no permeance, so there's just a regular plug flow reactor, now the stoichiometry says the flow rate of C and D are the same. So by increasing the permeance, you notice as I move permeance to right, the flow rate of C continues to increase. If I decrease the equilibrium constant, then you can see increasing the flow rate of D through the membrane by increasing the permeance has a pretty big effect on the flow rate of C. Now increasing the rate constant means I'm going to get to that value sooner. I'm going to get equilibrium limited. Here I'm kinetically limited, equilibrium limited. If I increase the diameter of the reactor, then I'm changing the permeance area. That ratio of area for permeance over reactor volume goes down. So I'm not going to be able to as effectively remove product D. So as I increase diameter, notice the flow rate of C is decreasing, the flow rate of D is increasing. So the idea is you can use this interactive simulation to better understand how removing a product in a membrane reactor where we have an equilibrium limit reaction can increase the conversion of the desired product.